Get ready to match the star. Joe Garagiola, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Forever Fernwood, Debralee Scott, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Oh, you're a lively bunch, aren't they lively?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are you ready?
Drunk.
Yep.
Well, then let's do it. Let's say hello to our two players here, Julie Martin and Anthony D'Andrea. Yeah. We welcome both of you. And before we start the proceedings, may we find out a little bit about each of you? Anthony, we'll begin with you, sir.
I'm a little nervous. No, I'm...
You're not nervous. You're not nervous. I'm laying hands on you and calming your whole body. There you are, calm.
My name is Anthony D'Andrea. I'm a bartender from the Bronx to Bronx.
Yes.
And the last time I was here was a long time ago when I was in the Marine Corps.
From the Marine Corps.
I didn't know before.
What do we got? A bunch of Marines in the studio, John.
I don't even know these guys.
I suppose if you say stuff like Guadalcanal and stuff, it'll get a big scream and a cheer.
No,
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 it doesn't.
No, but I'll tell you what will.
Halls of Montezuma.
Anything else you want to tell us about you?
No,
you're ready.
I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm
ready. Now you, Julie Martin.
Yes.
What do you have to say about yourself?
I am a theater arts major at UCLA.
Yep.
And all right. And I live in Hollyweird. And, yeah, kind of fun there. And one more thing that's very important. I am dying to kiss Richard.
Really? The only way you can do that is to win the game and win the money.
I can't kiss him now.
No, I'm sorry. It's not allowed there. Listen, would you tell us a little bit about the... He wants to kiss you, Richard.
Anthony, as far as I'm concerned, that's exactly what you are, chopped liver.
Thanks. Nice. Joe Garagiola played ball in the polo grounds.
Terrific.
I was a child at the time.
Okay. It's my show. You see, the way it goes is we do the jokes and we answer.
Oh, okay.
And you do. All right. Now, I've got to ask you about these. These are wonderful looking.
Oh, thank you.
How long does it take you to do that?
That's forever? A common question. 3 hours.
3 hours. Well, it's beautiful. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of the weirdos as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. And we'll go on to play that big money super match, which can pay off over $10,000. Good luck to both of you. Here we go, Anthony.
Yes.
A or B?
Okay, A for Anthony.
A for Anthony, he says. We are ready to commence. Larry said, I am never going back to that rotten Hollywood restaurant. I ordered a ham, and that idiot brought blank to my table. I ordered a ham, and that idiot brought blank to my table. Now, think about that, Anthony. Three, four people are ready. Two are still writing.
Oh.
Joe, you ready? Okay. Here we go, Anthony.
Gosh.
Larry said, I am never going back to that rotten Hollywood restaurant. I ordered a ham, and that idiot brought blank to my table.
A pig to my table. How fast I think.
Anthony, what these good friends of yours out here are saying is stay out of show business, is what they're saying. All right, Joe, here we go.
Well, I
ordered a ham, and that idiot brought blank to my table.
My hero, Telly Savalas.
Telly Savalas, yeah. He's a ham bone.
Yeah.
Your hero.
Sure.
All right, that's one good possibility. Brett?
I know, another ham. So cute. I just go crazy every time I see him.
You didn't.
Gene Rayburn.
You did. Charles.
I couldn't make up my mind between Hans Conried and so I chose Tony Rand.
Tony Rand. You had the two of those.
Oh, Harvey Korman. I got a few. I could get arrested.
Well, there are a lot of ham bones in our business now, aren't there, Debralee?
Yeah.
And who is the biggest ham bone of all?
Oh, my fave, Don Rickles.
Don Rickles.
Well, I figured, you know, he'd say that because he's... Never mind.
Yeah, because he does. He's a little frenetic, isn't he? Who is a ham bone in your estimation?
One of the great actors of our time, Charles Nelson Reilly.
Right. Are you beginning to get the idea, Anthony?
Okay. I'm a little late, but...
Yes, yes. You see, you can't take us too literally on this program. It's a figurative speaking, isn't it?
If I had stuck with my first inclination, it may have been a match. I wrote Brett Summers first, but then I said Charles Nelson Reilly.
That's
terrible.
Well, that's the way it went for him, Julie. Now let's see how it goes for you. Sally said... I've heard of equality of the sexes in a marriage, but this is ridiculous.
What?
Every night, my husband uses my blank.
Every night.
There it is.
I've heard equality of the sexes.
Oh, I haven't.
Right. Wonderful. Hello, Julie.
Hi.
Theater arts major. What school?
UCLA.
UCLA in beautiful Westwood. I love that area.
Ah, it's beautiful.
Sally said, I've heard of equality of sexes in a marriage, but this is ridiculous. Every night my husband uses my blank.
Pills.
I couldn't.
Pills? Tell me. You've heard of the pill, have you? Really? She's heard of the pill, Joe.
Yeah.
He's Catholic.
We don't have any in my neighborhood.
What have you got there?
We don't have any knees in my house either, but I put down hair dryer.
Nah.
Yeah, sure.
Hair dryer would
be... he could use her hair dryer.
That's, that's a good response. Hair dryer.
Sure, I thought that...
Use my hair dryer, right?
Sure.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing.
Okay.
I have hair, that's all.
Well, you're out of luck there, hon.
No, I said he used her 90.
90?
With your black lights, with your old things back.
Very good.
Thank you, John.
Very good. Charles?
Hot hair curlers, Gene.
Hot hair curlers. That would make him look a little funny.
That would.
It's a wonder that you didn't think of hot hair curlers.
I don't use them.
Oh, you don't use them? Oh, you
neither
just braid
Joe.
Yours. Joe doesn't either. Every night my husband uses my...
90.
90? Two of those so far. That's not a bad answer at all,
That's
Richard,
not.
Right?
Thank you.
Nightgown.
Yes, excellent.
Well, thank you.
Now, the lady in green.
You see, well, it's not easy being green. You see, with the difficult part about her answer, in some households, the pill is her husband.
Oh.
So it's the toothbrush.
It's what? A toothbrush. Yeah. So there we are at the end of round one, and neither one has scored. But now, they're going to get a lot easier. I hope. First, we've got this for you. All of these people who appear on this side of the stage will get the home version of the match game. Had a lot of fun with that. Thank you very much. Here we go to round two. Anthony, you went first last time. Julie, we'll ask you to go first this time. A or B?
I'll take B.
It is. Everyone will participate. Bill, the sports reporter, said, I asked the baseball manager how the team was doing. And he said, we're holding our own. And I went into the locker room. The entire team was holding their own blanks.
Oh, my gosh.
Go ahead.
You just go to the principal's office. That's what
This is a good one. This is a wonderful one.
I asked the baseball how the team was doing, and he said they were holding their own. When we were in the locker room, the entire team was holding their own. Oh, well,
yes,
that's easy.
Yes, of course. Put it right in the slot there, and away we go. Ryan.
I'm trying to concentrate, Gene. They got a new camera angle and everything. All this is coming in on me. Testing.
Come on. Charles, we're all functioning except you.
Well, I...
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go.
Okay.
Bill, the sports reporter, said, I asked the baseball manager how the team was doing. And he says, we're holding our own. And when I went into the locker room, the entire team was holding their own blanks.
This is crazy, but jock straps.
I'll say it is. Yes. What is it?
No.
They were hanging them out to dry or something. I don't know. Yeah.
Like the subway?
Yeah, that's right.
I think she braided just a little too tight.
That's right. Problem you have quite often.
Right. And when you braid too tight, it can affect you. But
see, that's how Joe got that way. He used to braid too. Now look at him.
I've held a lot of things in locker rooms, but never that really.
Never really. What have you got?
I put bats.
Bat. Yeah. Of course.
Which was my second choice.
They were a sports team, right?
Right. Baseball team.
Yes, they were holding their own balls.
Oh. That's great, Joe. We're looking for the answer, jockstrap.
Holding their own broads.
I see. Each was allowed to bring one into the locker room. Okay. Julie Martin is looking for the answer. Athletic supporter.
Well, that's not what she said. She said jockstrap.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's what she said indeed. What do you say about this team, Richard? The entire team was holding their own.
I think they're to be admired. I said supporter.
There it is. Two for you.
Is that as in, like, holding one of their fans or something like that?
Yes.
I'd rather not get involved. Thank you very much.
No, it's a little late for that. No, I said holding their own coach.
Holding their own coach.
Or coaching.
Okay. You weren't too thrilled with that? Now let's see what we got.
When Marines turn, they turn.
You are animals. Here we go. Say, did you hear that Richard Nixon got a magic set for Christmas?
No.
Yes, indeed. His best trick is making blank disappear. His best trick is making blank disappear. Right.
Good.
Anthony, yes. Did you hear that Richard Nixon got a magic set for Christmas? Well, his best trick is making blank disappear.
The tapes.
The tapes. Okay, Joe.
Tapes.
There you go. One for Anthony.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Tippy tap tapes.
There's two for Anthony. Chuck.
I have to give Anthony a rest between the winning. Did you ever go to 169th and Clay Avenue?
Definitely.
That's where I was born.
Right. Nobody cares.
Well, you die, know that, but Tony and I are talking.
We can't use all this.
Dr. Brodsky brought me. No, but we'll discuss it later. Tapes.
All right. Three for Anthony. Score is now 3-2. What have you got there, Debralee?
Tape.
Tape it is. Four. His best trick is making tapes disappear.
I am not a crook.
Oh. Yes.
Did it ever occur to you that tapes backwards is CPAT? Now think
CPAT.
About it.
Yes. Oh, yes, indeed. There it is. Got all six. Now, we go to round three. This is the final round. Since he's matched all six celebrities, he's going to sit back here and see how you do. You've got a choice of A or B. You've got to match four celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Okay, let's go with A.
A it is. Whatever you want, my dear, here it is. You do not play, and neither do you. The rest of you, please respond to this. Gloria said, I hate my new job at the fluorescent paint factory.
Oh, I don't blame her.
I've only been there a week, and already my blanks glow in the dark. There we go.
There we go, into the wide blue yonder. Is that a Marine song?
Yes. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here it is. Gloria said, I hate my new job at the fluorescent paint factory. I've only been there a week, and already my blanks glow in the dark.
Boobs.
Hello, Joe.
Hi there. It's the only answer, man, if you work at a paint factory.
Yeah. No, there could be other responses, you know, like her fingers and other parts of her body that come in contact with the fluorescent paint could glow in the dark. What did you say?
I have another song they might like. I love a Marine. Is that a Marine? Boobs.
Boobs. Score is now 6-4. Charles.
Boop.
There it is. Score is 6-5. She needs another pair to tie the score.
Excuse me one second. Would you turn those lights off one moment? Yep.
Yep. Right. That's right. They've blown the dock. Tie score. So, we'll tell you what happens when we get a tie right after we tell you about... Here we go. Now, we don't have time to play our regular tiebreaker, so what we're going to do is play Sudden Death. The first one of you to score a match will be the winner. We have one tie-breaking question for each of you. You will write your answers. You'll be playing with our three regulars, Brett, Charles, and Richard. They will not write theirs. Are you ready now? Here it is. Write down your response to this. Pennsylvania blank. Pennsylvania blank. And then put it right in the slot facing you so you can read it when I call on you. Okay. Pennsylvania blank. Okay, Julie, think of something and put it on that card. All right. Now, I'm going to call on our three regulars here one at a time. And if you hear your answer, turn that little device around so that we can see it. And sing out and let us know. All right, Brett, how do you respond to this? Pennsylvania blank.
Pennsylvania Dutch.
Pennsylvania Dutch. Neither one of them has that. That's not a bad answer. Charles?
Pennsylvania polka.
Yeah,
Pennsylvania
all right.
Polka.
We've got it. We've got a winner, Anthony Gandria. Congratulations. Julie, what did you have here? Pennsylvania Bell. All right, come on. Nice to meet you, sir. Take your coat. We'll get to you in a moment. We'll say goodbye to Julie. It was a pleasure to meet you. Good luck to you in your career. Julie Martin, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. All right. Now, Anthony, it's time for the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $10,000. To do that, we have two audience matches for you. And I want to point out, whatever you win in these audience matches will be multiplied by 10. That'll be the final dollar figure you'll be playing for. Here we go. Good luck. We polled the studio audience and we said you write down your best answer to this. Hem blank. You get $500 for matching the most popular answer, for matching the second most popular, $250, and for the third, $100, and you can call on three of our friends here to help you.
Okay, my man Richard.
Hemline.
Hemline is one.
Brett.
Hem, I can't read that.
Well, is it?
Hemlock, what I'd like to give Hemlock. Charles.
And Betty White.
All right.
Hem and Haw.
Hem and Haw. All right, Hem and Haw, Hemline and Hemlock are the three they've given you. At this point, you have the option of choosing one or giving us one of your own.
Okay, I'll stick with Richard. Hemline.
Hemline it is, what we're looking for. Let's go over here and look at the $100 response. Hem and Haw was Betty's answer. We want Hemline. May we see the next one, please? Mm-hmm. Hemstitch is not a bad answer, but it ain't Hemline. Let's see if it's up on top. Go! Hemline, congratulations. All right. You've got $500 there. We multiply that by 10, gives you $5,000, and that is the least amount of money you can be playing for. Let's go on to the next one now and see how much more money you can win. Slide it, please. Babe blank.
Joe Garagiola.
Ruth.
Babe Ruth.
Richard.
Is it Diedrichson, the golfer?
Babe Diedrichson.
Yeah.
Yeah, the famous woman golfer.
And Charles.
And athlete. Baby. Yes, Charles.
Good luck, hon.
Babe. Oh, I got it, baby. Great. That's it, sweetheart. Look at that doll in the green.
Babe. No, I got a better one.
Wait a minute. Hold it, folks.
He's thinking hard. No, it's coming to him.
All right, don't give me the fasty. I'm on now. Hi. Okay, yeah. Babe is Babe's in the woods. Babe in the woods.
Babe in the woods.
Why
and
am
Babe
I getting
Diedrichson
so excited?
And Babe Ruth are the three. What is your choice?
Greatest baseball player of all time, Babe Ruth.
Babe Ruth is what we want. May we see the $100 response. Babe in Arms is up there. All right, he wants Babe Ruth. Let's slide the next one. Babes in the Woods.
Toy
All right, that's the one that Charlie gave
Toy
you.
Toyland.
All right, let's go for the big Antonio. One. Yeah! You want another $500. Multiplied by 10, another $5,000, which add to the previous $5,000 gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for, Anthony. Now, we want to give you that money, but you've got to match one celebrity exactly.
Okay, the best. Dickie Dawson.
All right. Stand on the blue thing there. He hates it when you call him Dickie. Likes to be called Richard. You what?
Richard, then. Richard.
All right, Richard. Whatever you say there. Good luck to you anyway. Here it is. Worth $10,000. Blank Fool. F-O-O-L. Blank Fool. Don't say it. We call on him. Oh, now he's finished. You can say it any time now. Think of the answer that Richard has written on that card and say that answer. And if you do, we give you $10,000. Blank Fool.
No idea. Dumb Fool.
Dumb Fool. Let's turn around here. Yeah. All right, Richard, he said Dumb Fool will match you for the $10,000.
Anthony, I thought it was Money in the Bank. April.
April Fool! Oh, I'm sorry. Anthony, I thought you were really going to get that one. April Fool, that's too bad. Well, listen, it wasn't a total loss, Anthony. You had a few laughs and you won $1,000. We congratulate you for that. Now we've got this for you. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Tally-ho! Okay.